Today, every person in this gathering here has a cell phone in their pocket, and we all have easy access to the Quran. But the problem with life is that when things become easy, we lose value for them. When things become easy, we lose value for them. But when they're hard to achieve, you have the value for it. You know, I went to Umrah Hajj a few years back, and I was sitting in Medina Munawwara behind the Rawdah of the Prophet, behind the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there was a man from Mauritania. He was sitting next to me. So he was sitting next to me. I was sitting here. I was just waiting for salah. So I was just reading some Quran. I had memorized the Quran, so I was reading it off my heart. This man looked at me and he said to me, "Assalamu alaikum." So I said, "Walaikum salam." He said, "Where are you from?" I said, "I'm from America." He said, "You're reading the Quran off my heart." I said, "Alhamdulillah, I memorized the Quran and I live in America." He said, and literally, you know, he gave me this, like, you know, OMG look. He's like, "Al Muslimun fil America? There's Muslims in America?" I was like, "Yeah, there's a lot of us actually. We have a lot of Muslims there. We actually have Islamic institutes. We have, you know, HIV factories." I call these HIV schools HIV factories, because they just keep producing new students to the community, more and more children. You know how many kids in our community have memorized the Quran? I'm sure London is probably greater than Chicago. How many kids have memorized the Quran? It's a miracle. It's such a beauty that so many people have memorized the Quran. And we got into this conversation. Then, you know, by nature, I flipped the question on him. I said to him that, "Do you guys have, you know, and where are you from?" He said, "I'm from Mauritania in Africa." And I said to him, "Wow, you're from Mauritania. You know, have you memorized the Quran?" And then he gave me that look again, like, "You're crazy" look. He's like, "What?" I was like, "Have you memorized the Quran?" He said, "Me memorize the Quran? Every single person that's related to me has memorized the Quran." I was like, "Whoa, that's crazy. Everyone's memorized the Quran." He's like, "My mother, my father, my sisters, my uncles, my aunts, my wife, my children, my cousins, everyone, the entire family's memorized the Quran." I was like, "Wow." But then he looked at me and he said to me, "I want to tell you a little secret." I was like, "Yes." He said, "We don't memorize the Quran the easy way like you guys do." Now, he was getting challenging now, right? Confrontation. I was like, "Really? Tell me what your big challenge is. I'll show you my challenge too." So the next thing he told me, I realized that he was right. We have it the easy way out. He said that when we come to the madrasa in the morning, our teacher has a big blackboard and he has a piece of chalk. And each student in the madrasa, when you enroll into the HIF program, they give you a small little tablet like this, you know, like a small little blackboard, and they give you a chalk. And when you come to the school, the teacher will write the ayah of the day on the chalkboard. You have to write it on your small chalkboard, and then you have 24 hours to see that ayah. How many hours do you have? Then the next morning, what happens to that? They wipe it off for the next ayah, and you're never going to see that ayah again. It's gone. He said, "In our community, we can't afford hard copies of the Quran. So this is how we memorize it." And I was thinking, "La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah." People who don't have copies of the Quran value it. And those who have copies of the Quran, they let dust grow on it. Where was a community gone who actually valued the Quran? You know, who actually cared for the Quran? نورٌ على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى